attacking Greg Anthony. This is Kevin Harlan. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sideline. Look at Cleveland's starting group. We've got Bird. LeBron James is out there with Paul George. Then it's O'Neal. And it's Garnett in a power forward.
Give credit where credit is due right there. A terrific assist.
On defense, the Cavaliers. On the wing, Bryant. Back to Johnson. He feeds it to Irving. And it's tipped. It's stolen by Garnett. To the inside. It's stolen by Abdul-Jabbar. Outside, Bryant. Down low. Here's Kemp. That's in. Coming off an assist by Kobe.
And can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
Here's George. And you know, you look at the depth of the Warriors, never mind their dominant starting five, Greg. Their reserves are as good as some starting units in the NBA.
And for some teams, that can cause problems, where guys aren't playing as much as they feel they deserve. When you're playing for a team that's competing for a championship, though, players understand that some sacrifice is required. I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
O'Neal hits them both. Cleveland on defense. To the paint. Here's Kemp. And it's Kemp with the jam.
You know, that's what he's best at. Going strong with the hole, finishing with authority.
First quarter, just over a minute played. Outside, George. Got a piece of it. Pass to Garnett. And taken away by Magic. On the wing, Irving. Bird covering. Johnson kicks to Kemp. Irving attacking, and Irving throws it down.
Good. You have to love that pass, Kemp. Just the right amount of zip on that bounce pass.
And so it's Cleveland with it. Bird outside. Down low. Here's Garnett, and it's slammed in by Garnett.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. And so it's Golden State with it. Cavaliers making the shot. Johnson dishes to Kemp. Top of the key, Bryant. Six to shoot. Bucket is good.
Four up, four down. Nice way to start this one.
Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. James kicks to Shaq, and the dunk by O'Neal.
And that lead pass allowed him to get straight to the rim, unabated, in stride.
The Warriors have gone 4-4 to start, so a nice offensive rhythm to start here. To the middle, the kick out to Irving. Back to Kemp, and Kemp slams it in.
On the back end of that.
Yep, you're right. Finish hard with two hands on that stuff. Cavaliers have gotten their first three shots to go in for them to start off this game. LeBron outside. Cleveland moving the ball around. Bird, the pass to George. Shot clock at 5. It's stolen by Bryant. The Hail Mary from beyond half court is off target. Cavaliers trailing. And George kicks to O'Neal. Shoots from 14. And here's Bird from the arc. Good on the triple. Bird's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
There's hits he could go for a big game if they don't D him up on the perimeter.
There's Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the assist by Kemp. Kemp's got his third assist on the night. Now James. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. And George kicks to Garnett. Here's O'Neal, and it's sent back by Irving. Kicks it out to Johnson. Back to Irving. And there's the pass to Kemp. Doris, we know you were a standout point guard in the Big East for Providence. What players do you feel have a similar approach to the point guard position that you played so well in the NBA now?
Well, I was not your necessarily traditional setup point guard. I was a player who liked to get to the rim and get to the free throw line a ton. So I would say somebody like Kyrie Irving, who wants to be a dynamic scorer, handle is there. So I didn't mind passing, Kevin, but I wanted to score it too.
See, I picture you as like a Chris Paul, leaner. Could do both equally well. You could dish as well as anybody, but drive as well as anybody too. You're probably being modest.
I'm not being modest. I was pretty tough too. You didn't like to play against me.
But I like broadcasting with you.
Back at you.
Here's Johnson, following the basket by Michael Jordan. Johnson attacking. He gets it in there.
Now, I'm not sure how much more we can say about this guy's offensive game. He's so gifted. Plays like that are just simply routine at this point.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. That's good from Johnson.
I think everyone knows Cleveland is the team to beat in the East. They steamrolled through the Eastern Conference a year ago. And I think as long as their roster stays pretty much intact, they've got to continue to exert that dominance.
Jordan, here's Garnett, and it's slammed in by Garnett.
You know, the passing there deserves a mention. That assist was a thing of beauty.
The Warriors have gone 7 of 8 from the field to start the game. Very hot shooting. The wing, Bryant. James covered. Kemp kicks to Abdul-Jabbar, and Cleveland gets called for the foul. LeBron against Bryant. Back to Irving. On the wing, Johnson. And chance shot. Again, the miss by Johnson. And this Cavs team, a veteran-laden group, Doris, no question about that. They're great, but do they have a way to get even better?
Well, it's interesting because their core players are either at their peak or perhaps on the downswing, and they probably need to luck out in the draft or free agency to move the needle from here.
Wilkins has checked in for Cleveland. Jordan kicks to Shaq. The 9-foot shot, and there's another one for the Cavaliers.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here.
And for the Cavaliers, third time was that charm, right? 3 finals appearances in their last 46 years as a franchise, and they finally win the title. Now hang that banner, guys. What a tremendous accomplishment.
And it wasn't just the Cavaliers getting the monkey out the back doors. It was the entire city of Cleveland.
Well, how about over a half a century between professional sporting championships? It's almost hard to quantify what the Cavs win meant for those loyal fans.
Bryant with it. On the wing, Johnson. It's stolen by Wilkins. LeBron kicks to Jordan. Good, and the assist goes to James. James has got his third assist on the night.
And the lead goes right back. What a seesaw affair we've got going on.
I'll tell you, what a battle. Neither team giving an inch. The lead changing hands back and forth.
Tipped away. Cleveland's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Wilkins dishes to Garnett. In the corner, it's James. Off target with his 3. The Warriors trail. Kemp inside. Working on Garnett. Abdul-Jabbar kicks to Irving. Johnson outside. Kemp passes to Kobe. And change shot. Garnett with the block. James with it. Picked up by Bryant. Kobe with the steal. Irving dishes to Johnson. Passes it to Kemp. Kicks to Kobe. And again, no good by Golden State.
And boy, has he been struggling big time here in the quarter.
You know, clearly out of rhythm. He's pressing the issue right now. I'd like to see him get his teammates involved.
Warriors have gone 7-15 from the field to this point. To end the drought, and plenty of contact on the shot. So, two free throws coming up. And Cleveland gets called for the foul. The Warriors have gone 3-for-3 at the line tonight. First one falls for.
Well, Cleveland coach Teron Lue, of course, played 11 years in the NBA. Started, came off the bench, won titles with the Lakers, played on the worst team in the league. I mean, that breadth of experience seems to serve him well as a head coach. He's certainly seen enough.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. George is checked in. Now here's Wilkins. Here's Shaq. Cleveland moving the ball around. Wilkins kicks to LeBron. A second chance effort and the rejection by Abdul-Jabbar. And stolen by Jordan. Here's Wilkins. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession. Kobe, that's for two, and no good trying to get that one. It's a tie game here in Oakland. We've got more in store for you right after this.